In every project, a journey takes flight. Slow, deep, silent, hidden from plain sight. With patience, we mold each space so grand, sculpting the air with the masterful hands of talented crafters and visionaries. Each detail is a stroke on life's canvas, crafted with care like an artist's dreams. We shape the world, both near and far. With every project, we reach for a star. A symphony of vision, a quiet embrace, a creative endeavor, a sacred space. In this journey, we find our art creating wonders from the very heart. In the realm of architectural design, the creation of an idea is just the beginning of a fascinating journey. As you delve into the world of design, that initial spark travels through various solutions, constantly incorporating new data along the way. In my practice of architecture, I have utilized technology since my early days, witnessing the remarkable development of tools for conceiving, proposing, and coordinating architectural projects. These tools provide the potential to create virtual models of buildings in the imaginary realm, seamlessly linked to the physical world. This integration has revolutionized the concept of proportion, offering a completely different approach to design. This concept of proportion has always been a guiding principle. It's a notion that found its roots in my earliest projects, with references and influences shaping my understanding. One such influence was the Fibonacci sequence, which I initially incorporated as a reference point. As time passed, this idea of proportion took on a life of its own. It eventually culminated in the design of MIRA Residence, where I employed the concept to meticulously plan every aspect of the house. My goal was to connect the proportions embedded in the architecture to the grander scale of the universe. Through this process, I hope to convey that we are all part of something greater than ourselves. This is the story of how my architectural journey led me to this unique and meaningful design. As a modern architect back at the School of Architects in the 90s, the modulor, a proportional system developed by architect Le Corbusier, was the foundation of my design. It was based on the human scale, incorporating anthropometric measurements to create a harmonious and functional architectural framework. This system aims to balance aesthetics and practicality in design, reflecting Le Corbusier's vision of modern architecture. Another reference to human proportions is the Vitruvian Man, a famous drawing by Leonardo da Vinci, illustrating the proportions of the human body. Inspired by the writings of the ancient Roman architect Vitruvius, it depicts a man in two superimposed positions, with his arms and legs apart inside both a square and a circle. The drawing represents the idea that ideal human proportions can be harmoniously inscribed with geometric forms, emphasizing the balance and symmetry in architectural and artistic design. However, it was only in 2002 when I met one of my professors in Spain, Enrique Nueri, who introduced me to the practice of Carpinteria de lo Blanco. This craft, based on ancient guidelines written by Diego López de Arenas in 1616, involves tracing complex wood structures, a crucial craft in the Spain of the Austrians from the late 15th to the early 18th century. Enrique Nueri dedicated a great part of his life to revealing, in a simple way, the secrets of geometry to trace these types of structures. I had the opportunity to apply this knowledge to a contemporary project completed in 2012. However, what fascinates me the most is the geometric relationship between the proportions of the architecture and the natural proportions of a piece of wood that comes from the natural world, with measurements responding to an order created by something bigger, exhibiting a balance inherent to the natural world. Since the technique comes from ancient times, the human body, especially the foot, was used as a unit. Consequently, the proportions of our bodies were immediately related to what I was creating. In the final product of these types of designs, the experience is always a great comfort, regardless of the scale of the space you are in, whether it's a cathedral or a simple shelter. In 2017, I completed the Mondrian House at Yankee Point in Carmel, California. During the design process, I intended to give the design a proportion based on the human scale rather than standard procedures. In the process, I decided to use the Fibonacci sequence with the simple concept of the sequence 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, and so on. The result was balanced in terms of proportions and gave me the tools to implement the design procedure in my next project. A month later, after completing the construction of the Mondrian House, I received a phone call from a neighbor. He expressed his desire to develop a property, having been impressed by the other house. Seeking an architect with a different vision, he was drawn to the idea because the property was in a privileged location right by the ocean. He was open to granting me enough freedom to propose my vision without preconceptions on his part, as long as it was achievable within his budget, and of course complied with the strict regulations of the coastal area where the lot was situated. The property is located right at the beginning of Big Sur, a dramatic coastline which I consider one of the most beautiful areas in the world. Here, I see the power of the universe so clearly, the perfect scenario to create a design intended to make this connection evident. Once I established the fundamental functionality of the house's design, I chose to employ the graphic representation of the Fibonacci sequence in the simplest possible way, akin to Enrique Nueri's procedure. I started with a basic square measuring 1 foot by 1 foot, establishing a proportional relationship with the human body from the outset. Here's how the Fibonacci sequence unfolds visually. This process continues indefinitely, with each new square representing the sum of the two preceding squares' sides. The resulting graphic is a series of squares arranged in a spiral pattern. This spiral, known as the Fibonacci spiral, is a visually compelling representation that appears in nature, art, and architecture, reflecting the prevalence of the Fibonacci sequence in various aspects of the natural world. The floor plan was balanced with this pattern, using variation and points of encounters to create architectural elements. Simultaneously, this pattern was projected into the 3D space to form a container always referred to as the basic unit, 1 foot by 1 foot. The facade facing the ocean is an open window traced with the same pattern. From the interior, it frames the views. Since the opening was created using the Fibonacci pattern, it reveals, like a prism, the proportions of the universe outside. Intentionally, I incorporated many references to this pattern in different architectural elements of the house, serving as a motif in windows, doors, and sculpted on certain symbolic areas of the architectural composition. Finally, the third level of the house is a rooftop living area, designed to enjoy the place and connect with the immensity of the sky and the ocean, reminding us that we are just a small portion of something greater than ourselves. The intricate dance of constructing a building is a symphony of coordination, expertise, and collaboration. The construction process, a complex and multifaceted endeavor, stands as a testament to the indispensable role played by people, contractors, consultants, and engineers. At its core, the construction process is a meticulous ballet that transforms architectural blueprints into tangible structures. This metamorphosis, however, is not an autonomous feat. It requires the skilled hands and minds of dedicated individuals who navigate the intricate labyrinth of planning, execution, and completion. Foremost among these key players is the construction team, the beating heart of any construction endeavor. In this project, Their expertise and vision were vital. Based on their capacity, one of the most unique activities we decided upon was not to demolish the pre-existing house. Instead, we chose to deconstruct the existing house and literally cut it into several pieces to relocate it. This way, it continued to serve as a home, creating an inherent sustainability aspect in line with the goal we were trying to achieve. Like surgery, the procedure was done to make each piece of the pre-existing house fit into different trucks and be able to continue the service on a different site. In its essence, the construction process unfolds as a complex and collaborative symphony, where the construction team stand out as the indisputable linchpin for success. Their unwavering dedication, expertise, and visionary contributions not only guide the intricate path of planning, execution, and completion, but also infuse vitality into innovative approaches, making them truly indispensable for the success of the entire building process. This project serves as a compelling testament to that reality. The house is a cutting-edge example of available technology, completely automated and sustainable. The concept of domotica, or home automation, refers to the integration of technology and automation in a home to enhance and simplify the control of various household functions. This includes managing lighting, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, security, and other systems. The goal of using this system is to create a more efficient, convenient, and secure living environment by allowing users to remotely monitor and control different aspects of their homes through smart devices and centralized systems. Another crucial technical aspect of this house involves leveraging resources such as solar energy. The solar panels are seamlessly integrated into the architectural design, making them an integral part of the overall composition. Their strategic placement ensures the optimized utilization of electrical power within the house. Once again, the engineers played a vital role in crafting a solution tailored to the needs of the project. Finally, we also incorporate art expressions, sculptures, paints, and crafts to complement the experience of creativity, harmony, and balance between the human and spiritual worlds. One example was the creation of a sculpture for the entrance. To bring this vision to life, a remarkable sculpture was commissioned from a renowned studio in China. The creative journey began with the use of computer-based 3D modeling, enabling us to refine proportions and compositions within a virtual reality environment. This process generated a series of breathtaking, photorealistic images that enhanced our understanding of the sculpture's potential. To bring this vision to life, the sculpture's mold was meticulously crafted using cutting-edge 3D printing technology. The subsequent steps involved traditional craftsmanship techniques, culminating in the assembly of the sculpture using bronze. The result is a masterpiece of precision and artistry, poised to grace our project's main entrance. What excites me the most is being part of this new world, where the collaboration of diverse cultures, the seamless integration of technology, and the timeless beauty of art converge. It exemplifies the immense potential of harmonizing tradition with innovation, bringing forth remarkable creations that enrich our collective vision. As we reach the culmination of this construction, it signifies not an end, but the commencement of a new phase. Here, all ideas will have the chance to be tested, and as always, there will be room for improvement. In the wise words of Renzo Piano, one of the great beauties of architecture is that each time it is like life starting all over again.